Shabana Azmi stays on stage. Baba Azmi, Tanvi Azmi, Shabana Azmi have all collectively worked very hard, tirelessly and passionately to make Kaifi Azmi centenary year very, very special. And now, we wait to listen from a daughter, a special daughter, on her special father.
खवातीनो हजरात आदाब बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया कि इतनी जल्दी सुबह में आप सब लोग यहाँ इतनी बड़ी तादाद में आई हैं मैं आपकी बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ दरअसल जो छोटी छोटी तकरीरें यहाँ हुई तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हमारे अंदर सिर्फ जो हम प्रोफेशन करते हैं वही नहीं उसके अलावा एक शायर भी होता है क्योंकि जिस तरह से निखिल रंजन और अनुज पोद्दार ने अपनी बातें कही तो वो बिल्कुल मुझे ऐसा लग रहा था कि शायरी कर रहे थे तो थैंक यू फॉर योर ब्यूटीफुल वर्ड्स विशाल यू हैव वर्क्ड सो हार्ड इट हैज बीन जस्ट अ जर्नी ऑफ सच पैशन एंड आई नो दैट यू हैव बीन सपोर्टेड बाय द स्पॉन्सर्स बाय योर फैमिली एंड देन माय डॉटर नम्रता एंड हर टीम हु हैव रियली वर्क्ड वेरी हार्ड फॉर दिस सो थैंक यू वेरी मच हमने सिर्फ ये तय पाया था कि आज क्योंकि पेन फेस्टिवल कैफी साहब के नाम पर 100 स्पेशल एडिशन पेन्स निकाल रहे हैं तो वो क्यों निकाल रहे हैं उसकी ज़रा सी बात मैं आपको बताना चाहती हूँ कैफी आजमी साहब जो हैं उनको मटेरियल चीज़ों से कोई दिलचस्पी नहीं थी वो सिर्फ एक कुर्ता पजामा पहनते थे काफ़ी बार ट्रेन से ट्रैवल करते थे ना उन्होंने कभी घड़ी पहनी ना कोई अंगूठी पहनी ना चेन पहनी उनको मटेरियल चीज़ों से कोई दिलचस्पी नहीं थी उनको दिलचस्पी थी और जिसको वो वैल्यू करते थे वो था उनका कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी का कार्ड उनकी 5000 किताबें और उनके पेन पेन के मामले में वो सचमुच ग्रीडी आदमी थे सिर्फ फाउंटेन पेन से लिखते थे सिर्फ ब्लैक इंक या ब्लू ब्लैक इंक से लिखते थे और जितनी बार मैं आती थी बाहर से कहते थे मेरा पेन और मैं कहती थी अब कितने पेन मैं आखिर आपको दे सकती हूँ अब हर बार आऊँगी तो पेन दूंगी एंड ही यूज्ड टू टेक दोज पेन्स कीप देम ही यूज्ड टू स्टोर देम इन अ वुडन कश्मीरी बॉक्स विद सम फिलिग्री एवरी नाउ एंड देन ही वुड टेक दोज पेन्स आउट क्रश देम वेरी लविंगली रिमूव द इंक क्लीन देम पुट देम बैक अगेन टिल ही कुड डू इट देन आफ्टर ही गॉट पैरालाइज्ड आई यूज्ड टू हेल्प हिम डू दैट He used to also send his pen to a fountain pen hospital in New York, which I didn't know. तो मैं बोलती थी अच्छे कम्युनिस्ट हैं आप फाउंटेन पेन आप न्यूयॉर्क भेज रहे हैं 18 मोबलांग पेन आपके पास है तो कहते थे एक अमीर मेरी बेटी और बहुत सारे दोस्त हैं जो अमीर हैं और फिर कर लेते ऐसा हुआ कि मैं जो हूँ मेरे किसी फ्रेंड ने मेरे मुझे एक मोबलांग पेन देखा तो उन्होंने कहा तुमको क्यों देखा तुमको क्यों दिया तुम क्या करोगी इसका तो मैंने कहा मैं भी लिखती हूँ पेन से तो उन्होंने फौरन मुझसे वो ले लिया और फिर मेरे फ्रेंड को एक बहुत खूबसूरत खत और वो भी पोएट्री में लिखा कि वो पेन क्यों उनके साथ ज़्यादा बेहतर है बजाय मेरे तो ऑब्वियसली मेरे फ्रेंड जो है बहुत एक्साइटेड हो गए कि दैट वाज द करेक्ट थिंग टू डू हम हमेशा ये कहते हैं कि द पेन इज माइटियर देन द सॉर्ड आई सॉ माई फादर प्रैक्टिसिंग दैट ही यूज्ड हिज पेन to great advantage one of the advantages I just told you ke mera pen pinch karne ke liye unhone apna ek sher likh diya aur wo pen kha liya ek 40 baras ke baad jab wo apne chote se gaon mijwa mein gaye to unhone dekha ki ye gaon jisme unki paidaish hui thi wo waqt mein bilkul munjamit hai aur unhone tay kiya ke ab iske bawajood ke unko brain hemorrhage hua unka left arm aur left leg फॉर लाइफ पैरालाइज था उन्होंने ये तय किया कि वो अपने गांव में जाकर और वहाँ काम करेंगे उस जमाने में मिजवा इतना छोटा सा गांव था दैट इट डिडंट इवन हैव अ पिन कोड कैवी साहब ने अपना फाउंटेन पेन लिया और मुझे मोहसिना पिदवाई बताती हैं उस जमाने में वो टेली कम्युनिकेशन मिनिस्टर थी और उनको कैफी साहब ने एक खत लिखा जो पूरा का पूरा शायरी में था जो बेसिकली एक नज़्म थी जिसमें उन्होंने कहा कि मिजवा को एक सब पोस्ट ऑफिस की कितनी ज़रूरत है इतनी चार्म्ड हुई मोहसिना पिदवाई कि उन्होंने कहा कि मैंने सब रूल्स तोड़ के सिर्फ उस नज़्म के लिए मैंने वहाँ एक सब पोस्ट ऑफिस लगा दिया. सो दैट इज द पावर ऑफ द पेन. लेट मी टेल यू दैट ऑल द पीपल हु आर हियर हु आर रिसिपिएंट्स ऑफ द स्पेशल एडिशन पेन टुडे आर पीपल हु हैड अ वेरी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड पर्सनल रिलेशनशिप विद Kaifi Saab, and I'm very grateful to them that they have accepted this pen. I would like to tell you about my friend Bhavna Somaya. Bhavna Somaya ne aapko bataya unka kya rishta tha Kaifi Saab se. Unhone ye nahi bataya ki wo bilkul ek nidar khatoon hai jinka naam hai Bhavna Somaya. Achhe achhe mere jo dost hain wo Urdu mein baat karte bhi ghabrate hain, khas taur se Kaifi Saab ke saath. Not my friend Bhavna Somaya. Hamare yahan ek kahawat hai ki जब आप ये कहते हैं कि somebody is really sort of absolutely क्या कहना चाहिए उसको लट्टू हो गया, supposing कोई लट्टू हो गया किसी पे, तो वो कहते थे कि देखिए इनको जो है ना उल्लू का गोश्त खिला दिया है. ये है कहा, ये है महावरा, obsessed हो गए. तो आपकी जो फ्रेंड विनोद खन्ना है वो उस जमाने में रजनीश के यहाँ चले गए थे, तो भावना जी बैठी हुई इंतहाई कॉन्फिडेंस से कैफी साहब के साथ कहती, अब्बा मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि विनोद खन्ना को रजनीश ने आलू का दोस्त खिला दिया है. और उनको बिल्कुल भी कोई तकल्लुफ नहीं हुआ कि मैं गलत जबान बोलती हूँ. तो इनका ये खास रिश्ता था और इसलिए ये बहुत जरूरी था कि आज का ये फंक्शन ये कंपेयर करें. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर कमिंग. प्लीज फॉर द एवी टू बी श्योर.
इसी जमीन पर मैंने बोला होगा अभी मुझे बहुत कुछ इस गांव के लिए करना है और वो मैं करूंगा.
Extreme right, Mahesh Bhatt, who has written films he has directed and also films that he has not directed. British Nandi, who is a poet, a painter, art collector, and also a journalist, columnist, everything. Javed Akhtar ki kya tarif kare? तारीफ करो क्या सबको उनकी पोइट्री के बारे में पता है, सबको उनके गाने के बारे में पता है, सबको उनके स्क्रिप्ट्स के बारे में पता है. और आज भी मैं कहती हूँ कि मोगैम्बो मैं इसलिए खुश हूँ क्योंकि मेरे पास जावेद अख्तर है. ब्रिटिश, आई वुड लाइक टू बिगिन विथ यू. How did you really meet Kaifi Azmi? And I want to know in which language you all communicated, because you don't know a word of Urdu. At least I know one or two words. And Kaifi Saab didn't speak in English.
I come from Calcutta, and believe it or not, I was once 21. That's when I met. I was a poet at 21. I'd done about 15 books by then. And among other things, I had an audience who would listen to me rather rapidly in those days. Because poetry meant something to the people of Calcutta. around that time, when I was 21, Kaifi came into my life. I met him in a mushaira. For some strange reason, I used to be invited to at various mushairas where I would speak my poems. Kaifi was a star of that particular mushaira. Enjoyed each other's poetry, I don't know how, but we did. Bhavna is not particularly accurate when she says, I don't know Urdu, I don't know word of Urdu. I was at that time, when I was 21, married to a young lady who only spoke Urdu. So I had no option but to try and understand what she was saying, if nothing else. So I managed to communicate with Kaifi, and he managed to communicate with me. My inadequate Urdu and his faltering English met somewhere, and our poetry reached out and crossed languages to reach the audiences out there, which were in thousands. And it always amazed me why a huge Bengali audience would be listening to Kaifi or listening to me, both of us not reading poetry in Bengali. But we understood the magic and the power of this when in a few months of our friendship, and I would consider my friendship with Kaifi as, I would consider Kaifi as my best friend ever. He and I were great friends. There's an obvious difference in age, but we were great friends, possibly best friends. And within a few months of our knowing each other, happened the Bangladesh War. People crossed over. A lot of them stayed with me in the house where I live, in Park Circuit, which is just close to the Pakistan High Commission. Within a few months, couple of months, the Pakistan High Commission became the Bangladesh High Commission. And the young boy who was staying with me, who had very seriously injured his arm while throwing a grenade, fell in love with the Bangladesh High Commissioner's daughter, who was formerly the Pakistan High Commissioner. And they got married in my house. So I had the whole Bangladesh cabinet out there. Kaifi was always there. Kaifi and I then traveled into Bangladesh during the war. I remember Sukhdev was there at that time, a great friend of Kaifi's, who recorded some of those journeys. And I translated a lot of poems from Bangladesh, which he brought out in an international edition and raised a lot of money. Kaifi and I did mushairas, we raised money, and we raised public opinion for Bangladesh. They needed both at that time. Kaifi wrote a poem on Bangladesh, which was a phenomenal poem. I wrote a book on Bangladesh, a book of poems on Bangladesh. I translated the top poets and put them together, and another poet, Thambi Muttu, Sri Lankan poet, brought them out from London. And suddenly Bangladesh was everywhere. And I then realized that the power of language, that a nation would fight tyranny could fight an oppressive regime just because its students refused to give up their love for their language. When I look at the way we treat our students today in India, we call them all kinds of things. We demean their politics. We insult what they stand for. Students always stand in defiance of the system. But in that defiance lies the change that society undergoes. In Bangladesh, it was those students, those very same students, who raised the banner of revolt. It was not the fighters, the guerrillas, who were fighting the government out there. It was the students who were fighting. They were winning hearts, winning support of the people. All they had was a language. That was the magic. And both of us, I think, very strongly bonded during that time. We went out together there. I wrote series of poems on that. He wrote a lot of poems on that. But it was the sheer magic of that event made us best friends.
Can I ask you to recite the poem that you translated of Kaifi Azmi?
Okay. The one that I translated, I translated many, but the one that I would have read, I would have here.
You can choose one that you are very proud of.
Shabana has been very kind enough to send me some. I tend to look. Does it work?
Was that on the mic?
I tend to lose my books. That's always a problem with me. Since we were talking about Bangladesh, let me read his poem on Bangladesh. I am not a country that you can set me ablaze. I am not a wall you can raise to the ground, nor a frontier you can obliterate. This obsolete map of the world spread before you on the table is only a maze of wavered lines. How can you find me here? How can you find me here? I am the passion of the obsessed, the deathless dream of the oppressed. When man bleeds his fellow men, when exploitation crosses all limits, and tyranny breaks all bounds, I suddenly appear in one corner. I had eyes within some heart. You must have seen me before. Sometimes in the east, and sometimes in the west. In cities and in villages, where there are people, or even in the wilderness. I have only a past and no geography. My history is forbidden to be taught. People read it in hiding. I am both the victor and the vanquished. I execute my own murders, and sometimes I am myself crucified. The only difference is my murderers die. I do not. I cannot die. how senseless you are. The tanks you have received as arms, you roll them onto my heart. All day and night, you rain napalm on me. Listen. Listen. You will tire one day. How will you shackle my hands? My hands are 40 million. Which head will you ax? I have 70 million heads on my shoulder.